It's 8 a.m. and we're on the hunt for hummingbirds in the cactus garden at Stanford University.
This one right here, at the very top of these.
They flit around quickly, but with a high-speed camera, you can capture their micro-movements.
Well, it's really just amazing how you can take this camera out and view these kind of aerial maneuvers and slow speeds, because with the naked eye, you can't even tell what's happening. And it's really interesting that hummingbirds can hover like this, so we want to try to study that. When we build these robots, we want them to include this hovering ability as well.
The race is on to design miniature drones that can do everything from aerial surveillance to even delivering packages one day. But flying robots are still a long way off being able to navigate through complex and windy environments. Here at Stanford, a team of scientists are taking their inspiration from nature by closely studying the biomechanics of bird flight.
We have to better understand how birds actually fly so we can use the principles that they use to succeed to build better robots.
But the team not only studies birds out in nature, they're also bringing their research into the lab.
One of the methods that we use to visualize the flow field around a bird is by having very tiny particles in the air that you cannot see with your eye, but once we illuminate it with a laser, all of a sudden they become visible and they trace the airflow around the bird, and we can measure it actually.
But of course, the flapper is just a stand-in for the real test subject. Meet Roo, a trained parrotlet. Eric Gutierrez has trained Roo and other birds to fly from perch to perch and through the laser beam. But in order to protect the birds, he had to design tiny goggles for them.
The goggles that I make from scratch are the following.
They're tiny. This brings a whole nother meaning to the aviator glasses. I mean, these are fantastic.
Of course, the ultimate goal isn't designing cute avian eyewear. It's to build better drones by studying the micro-movements of bird flight.
If we want to do a drone delivery, right, you have to navigate in a city in a safe way, and we don't want drones to rain out of the sky. I think people have been inspired by how birds fly for a very long time now. Biologists have sort of an understanding of it, but to translate that from biology to engineering, that's by itself a real challenge. And engineers actually have different questions. So if you combine all of that, you can get much more innovation.